Hello, and welcome to today's video, where I'll be covering how to use the Shading Assist tool in Clip Studio Paint. Links to additional information are down in the description below. The Shading Assist tool is a feature that allows you to add lights and shadows to your illustrations in a variety of art styles. Whether you want to use this as a jumping-off point for a rendered illustration, or as a way to quickly add some extra dimension to comic art, this tool is really helpful in making the process faster and easier than ever before. You can access the Shading Assist tool in Studio Mode. To get started using the Shading Assist tool, first we have to organize our layers. You'll need to have your color layers and line art layers separated, then select your color layers. If you're working with multiple color layers at once, you can group them together in a folder, or make sure they're all selected before proceeding. Any layers that are included in the group will have the Shading Assist applied to them, so make sure you only include the colors you want affected. Something to note when working with the Shading Assist tool is that clarity is very important. The less color variation is present on your color layers, the more effective the end result of the Shading Assist will be, so it's best to use flat, solid colors as much as possible. Next, set your line art layer to reference mode by tapping the lighthouse icon in the layers panel. In Clip Studio Paint, the reference layer is a type of layer that informs other tools to follow it like a guideline. There are many ways you can use this feature, but for the purposes of using the Shading Assist tool, this will inform the tool to follow the shapes drawn by the line art, leading to much more accurate results. To access the Shading Assist tool, head to the menu bar and go to Edit, Shading Assist. This will open up a settings menu where you can make adjustments to the Shading Assist. With Preview toggled, you can see the results of the tool in real time on your canvas. When Refer to Lines on Reference Layer is selected at the bottom of the panel, the lighting will follow the edges of your line art to add extra three-dimensionality. With this setting turned off, only your selected color layer will be used as reference. The Strength setting dictates how closely the tool will follow your line art, so be sure to play around with this setting to achieve the result that works best for your art. Note that this setting works best when your line art is darker and thicker, so you may want to make temporary adjustments to your line art to achieve the best results. The first thing we can adjust is the preset. There are a handful of default presets that allow you to quickly establish lights and shadows based on a certain theme, like time of day or level of contrast. For more detailed manipulations, you can open the shading settings with this toggle. Here you have full control over everything, from the style of shadows, to the colors, to the blending modes used. Under Shadow Type, you can choose between cell shading and smooth shading. Cell shading creates harsh contrast with limited steps and value. The setting can create up to 4 highlights and shadows, which you can directly manipulate using the bar below. The number above each section dictates the strength of each shadow. You can adjust the placement of each to control how much of each is present in the final result. And if there are too many shadows for your taste, you can drag any excess shadows off the bar to remove them. Smooth shading has more realistic, soft edges. The Invert Shadows and Highlights setting will swap the placement of the highlights and shadows. Under the Highlights and Shadows setting, you can adjust the hue, saturation, strength, and blur parameters of each. The color dropdown will indicate the colors used when creating highlights and shadows. When Use Layer Color is selected, the base colors on your selected layer will be used, and any highlights or shadows created will be in reference to those base colors. Hue and saturation can be used to brighten up highlights and deepen shadows, while strength and blur control the intensity and definition of those highlights and shadows. When Use Base Color is selected, any highlights and shadows created will be based on the chosen colors within the Shading Assist panel, rather than your selected layer. For example, here I've chosen these two colors as my highlight and shadow colors, which you can see reflected in the preview. The blending mode dropdown controls what type of blending mode is used when applying these chosen colors to your art. When I set my shadows to multiply, you can see the shadows are now semi-transparent and have darkened the areas where they're applied. The shadow balance slider controls the scale of the shadows overall in relation to the highlights. The higher the number, the more shadows are applied. In the light source settings, you can swap between two different styles of lighting, ball light or directional light. Ball light works well for conveying a round, non-specific lighting source like sunlight. You can move it around anywhere on the canvas simply by dragging it where you'd like it to go. Directional light adds one light source onto your canvas following the direction of the arrow. This works well for conveying intense angled sources of light like a spotlight. When ball light is selected, the light position parameters allow you to set an exact placement for your light source. When directional light is selected, the light angle parameter lets you set an exact angle for the lighting to follow. You can drag and reposition this circle to change the intensity and position of the light source. When ball light is set as your light source, you'll see it take the form of concentric circles and two handles. These handles control the intensity of the shadows and highlights. The outermost circle controls the shadow balance. When directional light is set as your light source, the manipulator will take the form of a circle and arrow with two handles. Rotating the arrow will control the angle of your light source, and like before, the handles control the intensity of your shadows and highlights, while the outermost circle controls the shadow balance. Using all these settings combined, you can very easily create lighting and shadows that give your artwork extra depth and visual interest. I personally find this tool useful for trying out different placements of lighting and shadow before I settle on what I'd like to use for my piece, since it allows me to come up with multiple placements quickly and easily. With the use of presets, you could also find a great use case for this tool when working in comics, to make sure your lighting and shadows are consistent throughout. Give it a try and see how it can benefit your style of art. Those are the basics for how you can use the Shading Assist tool to enhance your work in Clip Studio Paint. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.
Clip Studio Paint.